In everyday life, you can recognize an acid by tasting sour, although many acids are very dangerous, so it's not a good idea to taste them. But you know vinegar, for example, that's not a dangerous acid. Lemon juice, they are acidic and they are sour. But chemically, what makes them sour? What makes them like they are? And the answer is that they are all made of hydrogen bonded to a non-metal or a group of non-metals. And that's what makes them have the properties they have. Remember that on the periodic table, the non-metals are on the right-hand side of the periodic table. The last group of non-metals is called the noble gases. The noble gases are inert. They don't react at all. And so they will never react with hydrogen or anything, but they won't react with hydrogen to make an acid. So let's exclude them. So acids have hydrogen, and we name the hydrogen first, or we put the hydrogen in the formula first, and then one or more of these non-metals. Notice that in this periodic table, the non-metals are shown with a blue shade. Let's take some examples of some acids. HCl. In the formula, we write the H first. That's a rule for writing the formulae of these acids. And then we write the non-metal, Cl, in this case. We could call this in words hydrogen chloride. And in fact, when this substance is in a gas, that is what we call it. But when it is at room temperature, it's in a liquid form, or if you dissolve it in water in an aqueous form, that's the more common form we use it in. And we call it hydrochloric acid. You just need to memorize that name, but it's quite easy to remember because the hydro tells you about the hydrogen in it, chloric tells you about the chlorine in it, hydrochloric acid. We know it's an acid because it has hydrogen and a nonmetal. Next one, H2SO4. Again, it starts with H, in this case H2, because it has two H's for every sulfate group, SO4. Notice that S and O are non-metals, so we have the hydrogen with a group of non-metals. We could call this hydrogen sulfate, because SO4 is the sulfate group, H2SO4. And when it is in the gas form, we do call it hydrogen sulfate, but it is more commonly in the liquid or solution aqueous form. Then we call it sulfuric acid. Sulfuric acid is a very dangerous acid. If you get some on your clothes, it will completely destroy your clothes. That's why in the laboratory you will never use concentrated sulfuric acid. It's far too dangerous. Your teacher will give you dilute sulfuric acid to work with. That sulfuric acid dissolved in water. Here's another example of an acid, HNO3. Again, it starts with H, showing us it's an acid, and then a group of non-metals. N and O are both non-metals. The NO3 group is called nitrate, HNO3. And again, the gas is called hydrogen nitrate, but the liquid and solution we call nitric acid.